Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in today's session we are going to study about degree of freedom. Degree of freedom means all the variables which are independent and necessary to define any of the component in its ideal condition. We will see what exactly degree of freedom is. We'll see different components and their degrees of freedom in this session. Degree of freedom is represented by F over here, and this F is represented into square brackets. Now we can, instead of degree of freedom, write simply F. Let us see the definition of it. Term degree of freedom is defined as the minimum number of independently variable factors. Now these factors can be anything, but they have to be independent and they have to be variable, such as temperature. Now for example, temperature is independent on its own. For any component, temperature is independent, as well as it is a variable factor. That means temperature can get increased or decreased. It's extremely variable. Pressure is again an independent variable factor. I can change the pressure of any system to whatever position I want. And composition of the phase, which must be arbitrarily specified in order to represent the perfect condition of the system. Let us see the examples of it. In case of a water system, if all the three phases, now which three phases does water have? Solid, which is ice, liquid, which is water, and gaseous form, which are the water vapors. So if all the three phases are in equilibrium, then if all the three conditions are equilibrium, then no condition needs to be specified, because the three phases can be in equilibrium at a particular temperature and pressure. What do we mean by that? That means if I have an ice cube which is at the sublimation point. What do we mean by sublimation point? It is known as the freezing point of it. Freezing point will have one specific temperature, one specific pressure point. And at that temperature and that pressure point, that ice will show three forms of it. Solidified form, that is ice. Liquidified form, that is water. And gaseous form, which is water vapor. Now this freezing point attains at a certain temperature and certain pressure. We cannot change the temperature, we cannot change the pressure. If we change the temperature, that freezing point will have been gone. And if that freezing point has been gone, that means the sublimation is not happening at all. That means there is no solid, liquid and gaseous form of it. If the temperature is increased, the entire ice will get into the liquid form. If the temperature is decreased, the ice will no more be in gaseous form or liquid form, but only in its solid form. That means at that one point, there are no variable conditions. There has to be a specific temperature, there has to be a specific pressure. And at that specified temperature and pressure, that ice cube will show freezing point, or that ice cube will show all the three phases. Over here, we have ice, which is solid, which is showing water in its liquid form as well as water vapor in its gaseous form. The system has no degree of freedom. The system at this point of time is not privileged of any degree of freedom, because we are not allowed to change the temperature, we are not allowed to change the pressure, or else this format, that is the format in which water is being seen in all the three phases, will be gone, or invariant, or zero variant, or non-variant. What do we mean by invariant, zero variant, or non-variant? Variant means variable. Something has to be variable. What can be variable over here? The temperature can be variable, the composition can be variable, the pressure can be variable. Anything which is variable is known as a variant. If I have just one thing which is variable, it will be a univariant. If two things are variable, it will be a divariant. But over here, we cannot vary anything. That means we cannot vary the temperature, we cannot vary the pressure, or else that point will be lost forever. And that is the reason why this is known as an invariant, or zero variant, or non-variant condition. The second example over here is, if condition like temperature or pressure is altered, three phases will not remain, correct? So if I increase, I simply increase the temperature. If I increase the temperature of it, all the three phases will not remain, because all the three phases are being shown only at the freezing point. Only at the point wherein I can see solid, liquid and gases is at the freezing point. If I increase the temperature of the freezing point, what happens over here is the three phases go off. Either the solidified ice will turn into a liquid. If I decrease the temperature, the liquid will turn into a complete solid. That is all that will happen. Three phases will not remain in equilibrium and one of the phase disappears. So for example, I have water, which is liquid. It turns into water vapor, which is gaseous. So I have a liquid phase turning into a gaseous phase, but there is no solid phase over here. We must state either the temperature or pressure to define it completely. What happens over here is if you state either of them, that is either temperature or pressure, what happens over here is the temperature and the pressure becomes constant. Now either I'm making the temperature constant or I'm making the pressure constant. For example, at first, let's make the temperature constant. So if I make the temperature constant, what is variable over here? The variable is the pressure. So how many variables do I have over here? One. How many degree of freedom will it have? 1 degree of freedom. Now instead of temperature, I put the pressure as constant. So what will be variable over here? The variable will be my temperature. And if temperature is variable, there is only one thing which is variable. Therefore, the degree of freedom over here will also be 1. How does this happen? Only when either of them is kept constant and the other can be variable. So we must take either a temperature or pressure to define it completely. Hence, the degree of freedom is 1. Or the system is known as univariant. So the next is, for a system consisting of water in vapor phase only, we must state the values of both the temperature and pressure in order to describe it completely. So over here, when it is in its gaseous form, there can be two variables, A, the temperature, B, the pressure. Why? Because pressure can be applied to gaseous material. Over here, water is in its vapor form. Vapor is nothing but the gaseous form of it. And since it is in its gaseous form of it, we can apply both temperature and pressure. If we are applying both things, temperature and pressure, we can vary both temperatures and pressures. Over here, I am not putting one as constant. I am just keeping both of them as variables. If I am keeping both of them as variables, how many variables will I have? 2 variables. The first variable will be my temperature, the second variable will be my pressure. And because of these 2 variables, it will be known as a bivariant. And this bivariant will have 2 degrees of freedom. Hence, the system has 2 degrees of freedom, or system is bivariant. Let's see the next over here. For mixture of gases, degrees of freedom is 2 because system containing a mixture of 2 or more gases. For example, let us take an example over here. I have N2 plus H2. It's completely defined by its temperature and pressure are specified. So over here, I have a mixture of N2 plus H2. These are my 2 gases which combine together. And when they combine together, there will be 2 things acting on it. Which are the 2 things that will be acting on it? The first thing will be my temperature. The second thing will be my pressure. Now, when my temperature and my pressure are acting on it, how many variables I have? I have 2 variables. The first variable is temperature, the second variable is pressure. If I have 2 variables, it will be a bivariant and the degree of freedom will also be 2. If pressure and temperature specified, the composition of that is third variable could be automatically definite, since it is necessary to specify 2 variables to define a system completely. Hence, the system is a bivariant. Let's see the next example over here. It is of a saturated solution. What do we mean by a saturated solution? A saturated solution or any kind of solution contains 2 things. The first thing is the solvent and the second thing is a solute. When I take a solvent over here, let's take water. And let's take solute as NaCl. So when I take a solvent over here and put some solute in it and I mix it together and they form one phase, and this is known as a solution. So to my water, I am adding some NaCl and mixing it properly. Once I mix it properly, it forms a solution over here. I take more NaCl and I mix it. And again, I take next excess of NaCl. After one point of time, the water, the amount of water taken will stop dissolving NaCl because the water has got saturated. It cannot take more of NaCl. But when do we come to know that the solution is saturated? When we add certain excess amount of NaCl into the water and try mixing it, and this time it does not mix at all. That means that those grains of NaCl did not get mixed because the water was saturated. So now what do I have in the solution? I have liquid, that is water. I have dissolved NaCl, so the solution of it. Plus, I have certain grains of NaCl which I had put but did not get dissolved. That means the solid form of NaCl as well. So that is my saturated solution. A system containing saturated solution of sodium chloride in equilibrium with solid sodium chloride. See, over here, this sodium chloride is my dissolved sodium chloride, but this sodium chloride is my solid sodium chloride, and water vapor is given below. Let us see this NaCl, which is a solid. Over here, I have NaCl and water together, which is nothing but a solution. And finally, I have water vapor, that is the gaseous form of NaCl. Are completely defined if the temperature is specified. Hence, the system is known as a 1 degree of freedom, because over here, I just have my solid and my liquid. I will not need any kind of pressure. The only variable I can have over here is temperature. And because that is one temperature, that is one variable, it is univariant, and a degree of freedom is also one. The other two variables, that is composition of NaCl solution and vapor pressure, have definite value at fixed temperature. So over here, what we are looking upon is only temperature, and that is the reason why the degree of freedom will be 1. So over here, in today's session, we studied about what is degree of freedom, the definition of degree of freedom, and different systems which have different numbers of degrees of freedoms. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and subscribe to Ikeda.